Hello, hello, welcome back to 237. This is Animal Part 1. I will be using a snow leopard as my inspiration. This is a schematic done by a former student and the inspiration photo. I'll be constantly looking at these photos to make sure I am on track with my makeup. That's a brown eyebrow pencil, that's a rainbow wheel, and then those two come in your kit, the white and the natural wheel. I start with the eyebrow pencil. I like to use brown because it's not as dark as the black eyebrow pencil. And what I'm doing is marking out the shapes, the basic shapes that I need that are going to be the different sections of color. So a snow leopard generally has a big background of white. So what I'm marking out is actually where my black will be going to create the dimension in shapes. I have my nose marked out, and I'm going to now mark out kind of where those puffed cheeks happen on a snow leopard. After I get done with marking out my different color sections, I will then start with my lightest color. In this case, that will be white. And I will work with all of my white sections first, and then I will move to the next darkest color, do that color, and then the next darkest color, and do that color. You want to work this way with the cream makeup because it bleeds or kind of gets a little mushy. If you start with your dark colors and then try to add white on top, they will blend in places that you don't want them to blend. So if you want kind of sharp angles, you need to start with doing the light colors first and then the dark colors after that. Again, these are different shapes that I'm going to be painting black eventually, so that's why I'm marking those out. I have simplified the colors of a snow leopard quite a bit, so you'll want to do that for like tigers or anything, or zebras, anything that has a lot of stripes or a lot of texture. You're going to want to artistically simplify it. So I'm continuing to do that. And then I will also show you in part two how to add a little bit of fur texture into your design if you so desire. It is important to know that once you get all of your white down or your lightest color down, I do powder in between with the translucent powder that comes in your kit and the powder puff. So I powder those because it will help it not kind of bleed into your next color. It kind of sets it. That's exactly what it does, right? It's a setting powder. I am marking my eyeliner with my eyeliner pencil. That just made a little bit more sense to me than having to do the brown and then the eyeliner over the top. Plus, I know that that's going to be black, so I'm going to just keep working with my eyebrow pencil or my eyeliner pencil for that part. I will fill it in with the cream color, however, I will not fill it in with eyeliner. Okay, here we go. I'm going to start with my white. You often need to do at least two layers of white to get it to be as dense of a color as you want it to be. Otherwise, it's fairly opaque. And you can powder in between those layers that you do, and that will help it make it a lot more dense of a color. So I will be doing this, and you will see me powder. And the video will stop before we start putting the black sections on, and then I will see you in part two. You'll have to pardon me, I mixed up my words. Opaque is what we're going for when we do two layers. Translucent is what we aren't going for. So again, make sure you use two layers, powder in between, to get that nice opaque white color if you are using white. You'll notice that I'm switching over to a brush here. Once I got my white down in my large sections with my sponge, I switched over to this brush. This helps me add that second layer, and it also helps me get into very small spaces that the sponge won't easily go into, and so I can add a really good opaque layer on top of that first layer. I didn't powder in between these two layers. You can or you can't. Like I said before, it helps the makeup kind of stick a little bit better, but you definitely want to powder in between your colors. So you will see me powder in between the white and then the black. I will not be doing the black again on this video. That will be in part two. So I will end the video with powdering, and then we'll jump into part two. So enjoy some music, and I will be back at the end of the video. There we are. I'm powdering. I'm setting that white in order to move on to the black. You will notice that eyelids tend to create what's called a crease wrinkle or a crease line. That's because the eyelid kind of folds over itself and there's more oils that get trapped in there. So we get some streakies. There's things you can do like primer. I'm adding a little bit more powder, and then I will probably add another layer of white as I keep working. All right, see you in part 2.